This is the second week on the job for 22-year-old Renee Alves.
So when you say you counted by ones, right? What do you mean by that?
She's assigned to this third grade class at the Dudley Street Neighborhood Charter School in the Roxbury section of Boston. But she is not a teacher yet. She is part of a training program called the Boston Teacher Residency.
Count by multiples of 10.
As one of 40 residents in the teacher training program this year, Renee will spend 10 months watching, emulating, and learning as much as she can from experienced teacher Kayla Morse.
And what multiplication equation can I write to represent that?
You can learn from a textbook, but I think it's a lot different when you're in a classroom and you're seeing it in person.
Renee's lengthy training period is part of a transformation in the way Boston and a handful of other cities prepare their teachers. While some teacher training programs require only a few weeks in the classroom, these residency models require far more. In 2003, Jesse Solomon, who taught math in Boston Public Schools for 10 years, co-founded the program that he likens to a medical residency.
One thing I saw a lot when I was teaching was a number of brand new teachers coming into the profession, smart, committed, hardworking, kind of willing to do whatever it takes, but not really knowing how to teach that first year. My concern was always that they were learning on the backs of the kids that had them that year, right? So if you're a first-year teacher in Algebra 1 class, you get another shot next year. For those kids taking Algebra 1, that was their shot at Algebra 1. And so had in my head that there's got to be a better way to do this.
Solomon's goals were to counteract Boston's heavy teacher turnover rate, fill key shortages of math and science specialists, and increase the number of minority teachers.
Our country right now invests in the preparation of doctors to the tune of about $500,000 per doctor. So we've obviously decided that to invest in the training of those doctors. So I'm not arguing we should spend $500,000 per teacher, but if education is really as important as everybody says it is, and if teachers are really as important as everyone says they are, then we should be thinking about how we as a country invest in the recruitment, preparation, support of teachers.
Renee spends Monday through Thursdays as Kayla's apprentice, and Fridays in graduate courses.
Okay, so one way I could do it is comp by 10. So
she and her fellow trainees will finish the residency with a master's degree in education and become part of the growing roster of clinically trained teachers in the Boston Public School System. 3 out of 4 of these graduates from the past 12 years are still teaching in Boston, a city where 1 out of 2 have left the profession.
What would go in this?
Kayla Morse finished the program 4 years ago.
I've been teaching at this school for going on 2 years. And what's kept me here is how this school is set up. It's a community of learners. So I feel very connected to the vision of not only preparing students for the world, but also preparing more teachers.
When you're thinking about how you'll work with Renee, are you mirroring a lot of your own experiences as a resident?
So a lot of times I do mirror my experiences with her, but I also think about if I was new to this profession or this place, what are some of the things that I would need to know to work better?
Do you feel a responsibility to kind of keep her fire burning?
Yes. Yes, because I think this work is challenging and it can really get to you. But I feel like what keeps me going is that fire and some of the same things we talk about with our kids, independence, perseverance, problem solving, those are things that I kind of carry through in my working relationship with her.
Roxbury has come a long way in the last 2 decades. These homes have replaced empty lots where city businesses used to dump their trash in the middle of the night. But residents still struggle with high unemployment. Almost half of the children in the area live in poverty, and the program recognizes this. Alongside comprehensive teacher education, the residents work with local community groups, not only learning about some of the history of the Boston Public School System, but about the particular nuances of the neighborhoods in which they teach. Here at the Dudley Street School, this approach has led to a strategic partnership with the Dudley Street Neighborhood Initiative, one of Roxbury's oldest and most influential community organizations. Program director Sheena Collier says even with 13 schools in Roxbury, more than two-thirds are bused to schools outside of the district.
We believe in parents choosing to send their child to school wherever they like, but we'd like them to have the option to send them to a quality school in their neighborhood if that's what they choose.
She says the Dudley School is an integral part of keeping kids close to home.
Unlike the other schools in our neighborhood, we were able to be a part of the visioning of what this school would look like, what would it mean for our community, what would it mean for the students that attend?
In addition to the forward momentum, teachers like Sabine Ferdinand, a graduate of the residency program, say it's important to recognize the challenging home environment some of their students may come from.
I have to be really mindful of everything that my students come into the classroom with. Students who come from a difficult home life.
How familiar were you with Roxbury beforehand?
Not too familiar, surprisingly. I grew up maybe 25, 30 minutes away from here. But before, starting to teach here, the residency took us throughout the neighborhoods and really taught us about where we're going to be working. And so that really allowed me to understand Roxbury.
Talk about where the answer was to 60 minus 30 in this representation.
12 years in, this program has shown success, not only retaining more teachers, but hiring more science and math specialists and placing more Black, Latino, and Asian Americans in the classroom. It hasn't all gone according to plan. A 2011 Harvard study found that standardized math test scores were lower among students taught by first-year residents than the first-year teachers coming from traditional programs. This trend continues until the fourth year of teaching, when scores in resident classrooms surpass their counterparts.
It was a pivot point. I'd be lying if I didn't say there haven't been lots of pivot points. It's sort of like you go institute a bunch of things, you get some success, but all that really does is teach you about the next challenge that you need to take on.
In response to the study, the program retooled, concentrating a greater number of residents in fewer schools.
So if you have, seven math residents and seven math mentors and a math clinical teacher educator, you have 15 people all in the same school talking together on a daily basis about what does good math teaching look like for the kids in the school. But I think the big question that we're wrestling with now is ultimately, are our teachers good for the kids they serve in the years down the line?
Only a few weeks in, Renee has a long year in front of her, but she says she's undeterred, driven by her time with the students.
When you have those aha moments, or you see a child have that aha moment and their face lights up, it makes everything worth it.